and listening and a lot of cognitive skills, just some fantastic stuff. So these students are well on their way to having skills that non-musicians don't have that will serve them well later in life. I think that's one of the things that makes Colorado a wonderful place for our students, because they have the ability to work up to this level at a public school. So the next piece they're going to play for you is called Sahara Crossing. Very different sort of a thing. Go ahead, guys. Cellos, which are easy enough to see. I learned today that the cello was often referred to as the bass violin way back when. You have to sit down to play it, and its lowest string is also a C, like the viola, but it's quite a bit deeper. Can you play yours, please? There it is. And then we have our basses. Three basses in this group, which is amazing. You know, if you think about middle school kids, the bass is about the same size as a sixth grader. And so it's really tough for me to talk sixth graders into wanting to play the double bass, but I'm the kind of teacher that I want them to choose the instrument. Because if they choose it, then they're gonna wanna play it, hopefully. Whereas if I say, "You got big hands, you're playing the double bass," that doesn't always go over very well. So I believe all three of these students started in sixth grade, right? And did any of you start on a different instrument before you moved to bass? Okay, so Emily, what did you play before? Emily does everything. She's one of those amazing kids who does everything. And then Courtney, what did you do before?
Violin.
Violin and Dylan? Was bass your first drum? So bass was his first string instrument. And he's done really well. Dylan is actually going to go to high school in Long Beach. And he had to drive there to take an audition. And he got into the orchestra with the seniors. So we're really, really happy. I'm hoping you're gonna recognize it. You guys ready? You know which one you're playing? Okay. Rondo, right? Okay, all right.
Thank you.
essays, and there's a wonderful teacher. She's just finishing up her second year. Her name is Elizabeth Stoyanovich, and she's building up the orchestra program. So we're really excited to have her, and I'm very excited to send these students her way. And then I know we've got a bass player, Courtney, heading to Drew Medical Magnet, but she has found an orchestra to play in outside of school, ICYOLA. And it was wonderful. They even gave her a bass to play, and that's the bass she's using tonight. She's already performed with them at LACMA and Getty, not LACMA, or the History Museum, right? Or under the space shuttle. They played a concert under the space shuttle. Science, thank you. And then they're going to be performing at Disney Hall this summer, this July. So it's wonderful. You take up music, and all of a sudden, there's all these opportunities open to you no matter where you live. There's usually a good orchestra. As long as you've got the right attitude and the skills, you can get involved and have people you have things in common with right away. Okay, so we have one more very lighthearted piece to play for you before we do our final piece. This is a fiddle style.